In this particular section of the course, you're going to look at proof of work in general and look at how does proof of work works and what is the reward and penalty and dive deeper to understand the same. Right. Now that brings us to the next understanding of consensus mechanisms called as proof of work. Okay, and proof of stake. These are the two most commonly used, okay, very high level consensus mechanisms used in blockchains, right? For example, proof of work is used in blockchains like Bitcoin, Ethereum, etc. And proof of stake is used in blockchains like Tezos, Algorand, Cardano, etc. Right? Proof of work is similar to a race. We have seen what happens in proof of work, right? So you keep changing the nonce value in a block to find a particular hash that satisfies a condition. If the condition is 19 zeros, that is linked to the difficulty target, right? Difficulty adjustment mechanism that we saw. Based on difficulty adjustment, the system will set, okay, now for the next 2 weeks, it is going to be 19 zeros, right? So the miners will start working on finding the nonce to satisfy the condition of the hash, right? So they will all race among each other. Every time a new block will be generated, there will be hundreds and thousands of miners working to find this nonce and satisfying the condition, right? That is called as doing some work, right? We saw this mechanism in the previous sessions that they will do this work to prove their honesty to the network. What is the penalty? The penalty is that they spend electricity, right? They don't want to lose that electricity for nothing. Yes, and that's the reason why they will not, you know, be hackers most of the time, right? So that is the proof of work mechanism. One interesting and staggering fact is that this electricity consumed by the Bitcoin network at this point in time, right, while recording the video, is equivalent to Czech Republic, the entire country's electricity requirement, right? It's a huge amount of electricity that's used for this proving this proof of work to the network. Okay, so even though proof of work works really well, because this is the reason, proof of work is the reason why till date for the past 12 years, even though there is a lot of monetary value that's there in Bitcoin, it has not been hacked at all, right? But it has some advantages and disadvantages also, right? Advantages that security, that this. Disadvantage is your electricity consumption, right? It's a heavy, a very inefficient kind of system, right? Where it uses a lot of electricity equivalent to, running an entire country for 2 months, right? So that's not something that we would want, because even today electricity is completely non-renewable, right? So we cannot waste this electricity on, finding a stupid number called as the nonce, right? Nonce does not have any other purpose in the block apart from, proving to the network that the node is honest, right? And also imagine the situation where the running race example, okay, five people are running. Why are they all running? To get the reward, right? But only one person wins, right? When only one person wins in the race, the other four people, right, ran for nothing. They will not get reward, right? They are not hackers. They are not trying to confuse the system also, right? But still, they are spending their electricity, right? It's like more like a race that is happening, where only the first person who comes is being rewarded and the other people are left behind, right? So that is not a very good efficient system in the making, yeah? So hope you remember this proof of work, how it works and things like that. Go revise that if not, right? And now we are going to look at a better mechanism compared to proof of work.